Hello, good morning students. Today we'll study something regarding the project crocodile. Crocodile belongs to class Reptilia. In India, we have got three important species of crocodile. First is magar, second is ghadiyal, third is saltwater crocodile. Magar crocodile is also known as marsh crocodile or Indian crocodile, and it is listed as vulnerable by IUCN. Its species is almost 4500 plus, and it mainly lives in fresh water found in the rivers, lakes and marshes. Ghadiyal is fish eating crocodile. It is listed as critically endangered species by IUCN, and its number is about 200 to 300. Small released populations are present and increasing in the rivers of National Chambal Sanctuary, Sone River Sanctuary, rainforest biome of Mahanadi, and Satkosia George Sanctuary, Odisha. Saltwater crocodile is the largest of all living reptiles. It is listed as least concern by IUCN and is found in east coast of India throughout. The population of saltwater crocodile or estuarine crocodile has increased in water bodies of Odisha. Large number of individuals are present, as a result of which it is of least concern by IUCN. Ghadiyal and saltwater crocodile conservation program. The ghadiyal and saltwater crocodile conservation program was first implemented in Odisha in 1975. The funds and technical support for the project came from UNDP and FAO through Government of India. Bolla project at Dangamal, Magar project at Ramtirtha, Ghadiyal project as Tikarpada, and captive breeding of crocodile at Nandankanan, Odisha. These are the four important projects. Indian Crocodile Conservation Project is one of the most successful conservation initiative in the world. It has pulled back once threatened crocodile from brink of extinction and placed them on a good path of recovery. The broad objective of activity under crocodile projects were to protect the remaining population of crocodilians in their natural habitat by creating sanctuaries, to rebuild natural population quickly through grow and release or rear and release technique, to promote captive breeding, to take up research to improve management, to involve local people in the project. Rehabilitation of crocodile. E-board strategy adopted for rehabilitation of crocodile was to protect them in their natural habitat, to rebuild the population quickly through captive breeding, rear and release, and to build up trained personnel for the job. The broad objectives of activity under crocodile project were to protect the remaining population in their natural habitat, to rebuild natural population quickly, collection of egg from natural nest as soon as they were laid, incubation of these eggs under ideal temperature and humidity, maintained in artificial hatcheries, hatching and rearing of young crocodiles in captive husbandry condition, marketing and release of young crocodile in protected areas, assessing the result of release along with the protection of the released crocodiles. To promote captive breeding, to take up research to improve management. Some of the major research activities are interpretation of various types of data collected during survey and census, determination of parameters for maximum success in egg collection, egg incubation, hatching, rearing, release, including husbandry aspect of feeding, food conservation and growth. Study of habitat features and population structure, study of behavioral biology including reproduction, thermoregulation, feeding, water orientation, locomotion, etc. to build up a level of trained personnels for better continuity of the project through trainings imparted at the project sites, to involve local people intimately through the following: the development of strong level of acceptance of the project by the people by locating the project in rural area where people could both see and participate in the entire program, protect the immediate and long-term interest of fishermen who resides within the centuries and whose livelihood depends upon the fish. Threats. The three species of crocodile, that is ghadiyal, that is Gavialis gangeticus, mugger, that is Crocodilus palustris, saltwater crocodile, Crocodilus porosus, are threatened because of ever increasing human activity in the river and their traditional habitat and consequent reduction in the extent of habitable stretches. The survival rate of crocodile hatchlings in nature is low because of predation. Management in the wild. Since the prime objective of crocodile project is to rebuild their population in the wild, restocking the sanctuaries with captive reared crocodile is an ongoing program. The protection of crocodile is round the year activity. Measured threats are from intruding fishermen using nylon set nets because of occasional reappearance of crocodile in their former habitat. There is now shared by increasing human population. There are occasional instances of nuisance crocodile. Such crocodiles are generally captured and shifted to some other rivers. Captive breeding of crocodile at Nandankanan. Captive breeding units have been established in Nandankanan Zoo. Mugger bred at Nandankanan Zoo have also been released in various rivers. Research and training programs. In-house research has been conducted to standardize the rare and release technique. Regarding their population assessment, egg collection, egg incubation, hatching and husbandry of young crocodiles and various aspects of behavioral biology. Training is also imparted to the staff employed in the project. There are various parks in India which are breeding Indian crocodile. For example, Jawaharlal Nehru Biological Park, Bihar, Sanjay Gandhi Biological Park, Bihar, Tata Steel Zoological Park, Bihar, Alipur Zoo, West Bengal, Nandankanan Zoo, Odisha, Nehru Zoological Park, Hyderabad, Kurukshetra Crocodile Center, Haryana, Mahendra Chaudhary Zoological Park, Chhatbir, Chandigarh, National Zoological Park, Delhi. So these are various parks for breeding Indian crocodile. In 1980, Gavialis gangeticus bred in captivity for the first time in Nandankanan Biological Park, Odisha. This successful effort involves the collaboration and coordination between international and national zoological park. Large credit goes to H.R. Bastard, which stimulates the Grial's natural habitat of deep flowing rivers with adequate high-rise sandbanks. The breeding enclosures, together with judicious mix of adult size classes to from social groups, minimum disturbance and provision of natural food, culminated in the success story which continues to the present date. Crocodile breeding, various factors are contributing to this crocodile breeding success story. Stimulated physical features in the breeding pools, good nesting habitat and material, social grouping of breeding stock with proper sex ratio, good natural diet, proper care of eggs and hatchlings, minimum disturbance and vandalism through education coordination. The broad strategy adopted for rehabilitation of crocodile was to protect them in natural habitat, to rebuild the population quickly through captive breeding, to build up trained personnel for the job. In these two maps, we can see the first map shows the distribution of mugger, second map shows the distribution of ghadiyal, that is Gavialis gangaticus, and the salt water. It is present along the eastern coast of India. I hope the concept is clear. Thank you.